Yes, why not?
Okay.
Right.
Hello, everyone. We have Dr. Ravi Ratan. He is a clinical aromatherapist and healer, integrating aromatherapy with lymph drainage and chakra and emotional healing. So please help me welcome Dr. Ravi Ratan.
Hello. I come from India. I come to US twice a year. This is my second time here. And I practice clinical aromatherapy, chakra healing, and lymphatic drainage. I'm sure a lot of you know about chakras. Do you? Can anybody tell me why they're there? Why are the chakras there? Everybody talks about them. Now? Everybody talks about chakras as the energy centers of the body, but what these energy centers doing on your body? They have a role to play in your life, is it? Now, few years back I was to leave India for one of my trips, and a friend of mine insisted that I should go and see a child in the hospital who was suffering from the adhesions of intestine. In the adhesions of intestine, the food was not moving. It was going, and it had to be taken out from the mouth itself. So the medical doctor, gastroenterologist, they did a procedure on the child, cleared the adhesions, but within 3 months, the adhesions came back. Then they did another procedure, but again, within 3 months, the adhesions came back. The third time, they cut that much portion of the intestine where the adhesions were there, but after 6 months, adhesion again came back. Now the gastroenterologist says that in 1 year period, I cut this child 3 times. I can't do anything more than this. The child was in ICU. Why don't you call somebody who does some alternative healing? Maybe let them try something on the child. That's why we were called. In India, doctors still believe in the alternative ways. So we went to the ICU, we worked on the child, we checked the chakras, we used our chakra oils, energy work. By third day, adhesions started clearing up, positive sign. By fifth day, food started moving. In a week, the child was out of ICU. And when we were working on the child at the hospital, the gastroenterologist comes and asks us, tell me how does it work? How could you do it? Now, what do I tell a medical doctor about chakras? Because they have done all their work on dead bodies. And dead bodies don't have chakras. Okay? Now, today, it is easy to convince a doctor or a scientific mind about chakras and energy because we have devices to measure energy. Okay? We have devices to take all our pictures. A healthy human being's energy, when it's measured, is between 62 to 76 megahertz. Megahertz is the measure of energy. And what happens to our energy when we have a negative thought or emotion? This energy goes down. Stress, anxiety, depression, everything brings your energy down. How do you raise this energy back? By some positive thinking, rest and all that. Okay? But if your energy keeps going below 58 megahertz, we start inviting disease in the physical body. Doctors call it psychosomatic disorders. That means mind over body. But they are trying to do all the research, what causes what? What causes, say, depression? What causes breast cancer? What causes headaches and migraines in people? But if you understand the chakra system, you will understand how it works. Now, that's what I'm trying to explain to you. Now, first thing, how do you nourish the energy of the physical body? To nourish the energy of the physical body, all of us eat something called food. And different kind of food provide us energy at different level. 0 to 10 is the energy of all the food which is refrigerated and preserved. When you eat that kind of food, your tummy is filled, but your body feels lethargic. You need to rest. Is it? 10 to 20 is the energy of all the food which we say fresh food, but it doesn't give you much nutrition because today we have a lot of GM food. 20 to 30 is the energy of the food we say organic, or eco-harvested. We prefer having that kind of food because we want more nutrition for the body. And 30 to 40 is the energy of the food, which is living food. And what is living food? Something like sprouts. That's why Ayurveda has always recommended that we should soak our almonds in the night and eat them in the morning. And the simple thing, the enzyme activity begins and they become alive. Okay? Now, you can choose your food rationally or you can go by the taste buds. But once the food is inside the body, you do not have any control. Where it is going, which organ it is going, you do not control. What controls is your body's autonomous nervous system or your body's intelligence. And you know what your body intelligence decides? It wants to ensure that you survive. Okay? For your survival, nutrition has to first go to your vital organs. See, when people are not healthy physically, mentally or emotionally, either they do not eat well or they do not absorb well. In either case, the deficiency of nutrition is passed on to one organ of the body. You know which one? Your skin and hair. That's why in aromatherapy practice we say your skin is the mirror of your health. Because your body intelligence cannot cut down nutrition from any other organ. Because all other organs are vital organs, your survival depends on them. If something happens, you get a major disease. So this is how the energy is supplied to different organs of the body. And you must have studied in school a basic principle of energy that it can neither be created nor destroyed. It only changes form. So different organs, when they use energy, release a certain amount of process energy. And that process energy converges to the points we call chakras and releases out of the body. So chakras are the points, the energy center, which are releasing the energy which has been used in the body or the process energy. They are representing the activities of your organs and glands. So I call that they are the barometers of your health. Say if a heart chakra represents the energy of your heart, your lungs, your thymus, your solar plexus is representing the energies of your digestive organs, so and so on. Different chakras represent energy at different frequency, which is not being released like a jet, which envelops your physical body. That's what makes your energy body or your aura, which we say has seven colors, because frequency of different chakra is at different level. Now, when these chakras are forming, when a child is conceived in the mother's womb, the first organ which forms is the brain and the hypothalamus. And when the brain and the hypothalamus forms, opens your crown chakra. And when the crown chakra opens, your consciousness comes, the individual consciousness comes to the body. We can say your soul is coming to the body. And this consciousness, when it comes to the body, brings the complete blueprint of your life. That blueprint means which set of parents you will be born to, what kind of body you will have, what kind of relationship, everything there is already there in the blueprint. And that blueprint is based on your past life karma. Okay, whether you believe in karma or not, it works. So that blueprint ensures, like when you go to a psychic, astrologer, palm is there trying to read that blueprint, that is your destiny, but nobody can change it. Once the crown chakra opens, this consciousness which has come on the crown chakra flows all the way down, settles at the end of the spine, at we call it root chakra. Your base root chakra gets activated, your physical body starts forming. It takes 9 months in the mother's womb, but it takes 7 more years to develop completely. You know, a newborn baby doesn't even have well-developed kneecaps. It takes 2 years for the kneecaps to develop. So your physical body takes 7 years to develop completely. Any imbalance of the root chakra in the first 7 years may lead to physical disability for life. You know, all the congenital defects, all these kind of problems, they all happen in the first 7 years. Your root chakra, in Ayurveda and Tantra, they associate with element earth. You know, we talk of five elements, earth, water, fire, air and ether. And the element earth is connected with the root chakra. And when I'm saying earth element, I'm not talking of rock, mountain, bricks, and sand. None. Ayurveda and Tantra says we are the microcosm of the macrocosm. What is this Mother Earth made up of? It's made up of minerals, metals, flora, and fauna. All that exist in physical body. How many of you eat supplements? A lot of you eat supplements. Why? Because you want to maintain the balance of those minerals, metals in your body. If your physical body is imbalanced with those mineral and metal, it gets affected. Like if you have calcium deficiency, what will you have? Osteoporosis, arthritis and all. Iron deficiency may lead immune system problem. Magnesium, potassium, selenium, all the minerals, they affect the physical body. And where do you get them? You get all these minerals from the food you eat. Whether the food is vegetarian or non-vegetarian, comes from earth and gives you all this. A lot of time people talk of root chakra and we talk of something called grounding. What is grounding? Connected to earth? All of us are connected to earth by law of gravity. Nobody is flying. Okay? So grounding is not just the connected, being connected to earth. Grounding is being focused in what you are doing, being in the moment. And if you are not focused in what you are doing and your mind drift off to something else, what will happen? You will make mistakes. And if you make mistakes, there are obstacles in life. That's why a lot of time when people are preoccupied, their mind is preoccupied, they keep making mistakes and they have to do the same thing over and over again. They face obstacles in life. That's what the root chakra is about. Grounding. Now, when we say each chakra is an energy center, energy at different chakra has different roles. The root chakra energy is called apana vayu. Vayu means energy. And the role of this energy is elimination. We get energy from crown chakra, eliminate that energy from root chakra because these vital pranas circulate in the body. We eat, we defecate. We drink, we urinate. So all this activity of elimination is controlled by root chakra. And this works like a flush valve. If you are sitting and you have the urge to go, you can control yourself. When you go, you can let go. But if your root chakra is leaking, that means like a flush valve leaking, and you know when the flush valve is leaking, there is a continuous drip. Same way, if your root chakra is leaking, there is a continuous leakage of energy from the physical body. And if there is a leakage of energy, what will happen? People will feel tired all the time. You know, people call it adrenal fatigue or the chronic fatigue syndrome, which is mainly because the root chakra is leaking. That's why in yoga, they teach you an exercise. You know, like Kegel exercise? If you do that exercise, it can control the leakage of the root chakra. Your second chakra, 7 to 14 years is the age for the sacral chakra. You know, everybody thinks sacral chakra is only about sexuality because this chakra, this is the phase a child attains puberty. But sexuality is just a very small part of the second chakra. The most important area about second chakra is emotional balance. And you know why emotional balance? Because the element associated with the sacral chakra is water. Like this body is two-thirds of water, earth is two-thirds of water. Now what happens to the water on earth with the lunar cycle change? You see high tide and low tide? How many of you experience mood swings when there is a full moon? Lunar cycle affects people because you see the water outside, you don't see the water inside, your body gets also affected by the lunar cycles because the water in the body has a magnetic, it's a biomagnetic fluid which gets affected by the moon phases. So this chakra is also about your emotional balance because moon affects your emotions. Now, I deal with something called lymphatic system. How many of you know about lymphatics? Good. Now, all fluids in the body are controlled by your second chakra, as the energy associated with this chakra is called Vyana Vayu, which regulates circulation in your body. Now, we are all emotional beings, and the major lymph nodes in our body are in the groin area, we call inguinal nodes, and in the underarm, we call axillary nodes. Now, when we experience something like an emotional blockage, what will happen? Emotion which we are not able to express, it blocks your second chakra energies. When the second chakra energy is blocked, it affects the flow of the lymph in the body, especially in the lymph nodes. Over a period of time, if temperamentally somebody is not able to express, what will happen? This chakra will get blocked. It will also affect the throat chakra because somebody is not able to express. It starts showing like a menstrual imbalance. That's the first sign. Especially, you see, this is the phase 7 to 14. Child starts getting puberty, so menstrual cycle gets affected. Now, people do not understand the cause of this and they start giving pills just to balance it without treating the cause. Over a period of time, this problem aggravates, like your body is like a bag of water, and a bag of water you push from one side, what happens? The pressure goes on the other side. So people who suffer from lower back pain, which does not resolve by anything, you do massages, you do chiropractic, but the pain stays there. It is coming because your second chakra is blocked, your lymph nodes are blocked. I was in Massachusetts 3 years back doing a healing session on a lady who was recommended by her chiropractor to come and see me. She was seeing the chiropractor for past 5 years, once a week, for a lower back pain which was not resolving. When I had her on the table, my way is like I check chakra with my pendulum, and then while putting the chakra oils, I try to feel the lymph nodes. And the moment I feel the lymph nodes, I can make the emotional blockages. The principle is simple. Your issues are in your tissues. After some time, your brain forgets everything, but the body remembers. So all emotional blockages get stuck somewhere in your body, like the muscle knots. So I touched that area, and I felt the emotional blockages. I told her, your emotional blockages, and she said, I cannot have emotional blockages. I said, why? She said, I have excellent family relationship. I have 2 boys, very nice kids. Me and my husband don't fight, so why should I have emotional blockages? I said, you are talking of all male members, because the right side of the body is masculine, left side is feminine, and I am seeing blockages in the left side. Let's talk about your mother and sister. You don't have a daughter. And she said, I am not in touch with them anymore. I said, there you are. They are all sitting here. You are not in touch, but they are sitting here. What happened? And she said, I was 13 of the 14 children from my mother who never had time for me. And my sisters used to bully me, so when I grew up, I just walked out of the family. I said, they are all sitting. They are the cause of your lower back pain. So first people have to realize from where the blockages are coming. Then you clear the lymph node and the back pain goes. You know, even a simple thing like cellulite. Cellulite is also the result of the lymphatic blockages. Because when lymph is not moving, the toxins are not moving, your body intelligence throws those toxins to the extremities and they show as cellulite in the body. Now 14 to 21 is the age for the solar plexus. I'll take the questions after the thing. 14 to 21 is the age for the solar plexus. That means a child is developing their mind of their own. This is the phase child develops his own mind. It's about your ambitions in life. When people are very ambitious, what they do? They become multitask. They keep do multitasking. Their mind is not at one place. They keep pushing themselves physically, mentally, and it increases their body heat because this chakra is associated with element fire. Okay, their liver gets heated. So when people are pushing themselves so much, liver gets heated, they are the ones who are prone to headaches and migraines. They are the ones who are prone to high cholesterol. They are the ones who are prone to hypertension, high blood pressure, diabetes, all that comes over here because of the solar plexus action. Anybody does yoga here? In yoga, they teach you a simple exercise. It's called alternate nostrils breathing. If you do that, it will balance your sacral and solar plexus chakra, your blood pressure, your headaches and migraines. That's the easiest way you can regulate your health. Your lower three chakras are about your survival in the material world. Then comes your heart chakra. 21 to 28, we say it's about your relationship and love, is it? And people you love the most give you maximum pain in life. Why? Because what you think your love is actually not love. That's your attachments to people and things. As long as you have attachments, the only thing you get in return is pain, anguish and trauma. And when you get pain, anguish and trauma, the heart chakra energies are affected, these lymph nodes get blocked. When these lymph nodes are blocked for a long period of time, what will it do? Cause breast pain, breast lumps and breast cancer. The simple thing, press on the side of your breast. If it is tender, feel it here. If it is convex, your lymph nodes need to be cleansed out. You know, you take bath every day, but how many of you massage this area properly and clear the lymph nodes? You know, all these companies making bras, they promote the bra, but has anybody ever told you when you remove it, rub the bra line so that you clear the congestion up to the thing, so your breast is stay healthy? Today, all these cases of breast cancer are there because nobody has cared for them. We have taken all this for granted. Then comes your throat chakra. Throat chakra is about your expression, but this chakra gets affected by all the lower chakras. When you are not able to express your emotions easily, what happens? There are lymph nodes here. We call them submandibular nodes. There are lymph nodes in the front of the ear, behind the ear. They get blocked. So, if there is a blockage here, what will happen? Your thyroid will get affected. Maximum cases of thyroid because this. So when somebody came to me a few years back in a show, asked me help with the thyroid, I said, not only you have to work on the throat chakra, you have to work on the lower chakra. I do chakra oils, and she wanted only the throat chakra. I said, no, you use all seven. Because this chakra gets affected by the lower chakra, you clear that. And I always tell people when I promote my skin oil for the face, to massage face, make fingers like this from front and back. Here. When you massage from here to here, you clear your lymph nodes here. Clear your lymph nodes here. Because if these lymph nodes are congested for a long time, it also causes one more problem. Tinnitus. Ringing of the ears. Okay? So you need to clear this. And when throat and third eye are not connected, people can't comprehend their thoughts. They can't express their thoughts properly. And this chakra gets blocked too. And finally is the crown chakra, which is our connection to the highest consciousness. And in our journey of life, we keep pushing ourselves, trying to make money, ambitions and all that, and we lose this connection. And when we get into the path of spirituality, we try to reestablish this connection. People try to meditate, but if your mind is too busy, how can you meditate? So the easiest way of doing is by chanting. Or you can do chanting on the chakra seat syllables from one to another, by the time you reach here, if your mental divergence stops, you could meditate. I have my brochures here, if you have got it, otherwise you can come to my booth about chakra meditation. I have my book and my CD with the meditation. Anybody wants to learn more, I'll be doing classes on Monday and Tuesday evening. You can collect the information. Because my time here is over. If you have any questions and you want to discuss more, please come to my booth. Thank you very much. Namaste.